Hey you guys, hello and welcome. I hope you guys are all having a really wonderful day. So this is my second time filming this video because the first time it was just super long-winded and I could have made it so much more condensed and concise. And I said something so stupid. I was like, "Hey you guys, it's October where I live." And I'm like, "Where is it not October?" Anyways, so today I'm going to be talking about lifting canna lilies. So these over here are a tender perennial plant. They're a bulbous plant too. This here applies to lifting dahlias. It also applies to lifting gladiolus lilies, calla lilies, gloriosa lilies, and many other plants that, like hardy gluckinia too, which wouldn't normally survive the course of the winter. So we're in our autumnal season here in British Columbia, Northern Hemisphere. And temperatures are starting to dip quite low. It's mid-October when I'm filming this. I'm not sure when I'm gonna upload this, probably also mid-October, because then it would have more relevance. But I have this bed here that I grew a lot of Asiatic lilies. I grew 4 o'clock or Mirabilis jalapa here, or jalapa. I also grew gladiolus lilies and cannas. So this over here is Picasso. It's a dwarf variety of canna. What I did was I essentially dug around with a spade and then I lifted the clump. So this over here is a second year clump. It has the reason why I really wanted to show you this now is because it has active seed producing structures, has a little bit of desiccating foliage that shows a little bit of frost damage. It has decently healthy roots and it has intact bulbs too, and it also has new growth. So the reason why we do this in the garden is because we want to preserve many of our specimens over the course of the season, so that we can enjoy their blooms and their edible qualities later on into further persisting seasons. It just extends the longevity of your plants. If you buy them as an investment, it gives you more chance to enjoy them and grow them and cultivate them. And yeah, so this over here is a type of plant that we're going to be storing in a dormant stage. Many other semi-woody and tender perennial plants you want to store in an active growing season stage or in a semi-dormant stage with their foliage intact. The reason why you would do that is because it makes it easier for them to awaken from their dormancy in March and April when you plant them right back in the garden. But for these guys over here, you want them to be in a fully dormant state. So I just dug around them and I shook a pretty generous amount of the root material, the desiccated root material and the growing media off. I just wanted to show you some of the anatomy of this plant. So you can tell it's a bulbous plant because it has this really pronounced engorged area on the lower basal stem. It has new growth off-budding from it. It has adventitious roots and it has a sheath. So one of the things that you want to do with these is you're going to want to prune the roots off a little bit right on the tips because they get a little bit of frost damage to them. Another thing you're going to want to do is really make sure that you preserve the new growing points because these over here are what's going to give you your blooms for next year. You want to identify which parts of the plant have already bloomed. They'll be oftentimes the most desiccated part of the plant because they've extinguished a lot of their energy. And that happens to be this part right over here. These parts here are current season growth. You're going to want to remove those too because they're not going to rebloom from you, for you, but you're going to want to wait until they turn brown. So the next thing that I do is I cut off the vast majority of the foliage, just to clear space. It's a little bit less material to rot while you're storing it during the winter. So I just got my shears here, or my secateurs rather, and I'm just going to go in. This is another one. This is also Picasso, and I'm just going to prune up till about an inch, inch and a half above soil level. You're gonna want to try to make your cuts as clean as you can. This here just eliminates excess stuff that can potentially rot during storage. Okay. This is really hard to do with one hand. So now we got our clump. So now what we're gonna want to do is we're gonna want to find a location that's dark, decently dry, low humidity, humidity around 20%, but not fully dry, and approximately 8 degrees Celsius. This temperature range really does support the dormant stage in many plants. So what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to check on this Several times during the winter season, I do it about once every week and make sure that it has enough moisture in the root zone to be able to keep these new growing points alive, but it doesn't have so much that it rots. You're gonna wanna wait until about March or April when this here starts to produce a little bit more vertical growth. And that's when the plant will sort of let you know that it's about to awaken. This is a good time of the year to divide them. I'm pretty happy with the size of these clumps, so for that reason I'm not going to divide them. But you can get a pitchfork or a large trowel or a knife and just cut them in half right along the center. Once again, that's really hard to show with just one hand because I'm filming too. You can definitely compost these. I did not wait for this here to fully turn brown, but that's because with our daylight hours I don't think it would get a lot more photosynthesis, so it's not really feeding the bulbs so much at this time given our climatological conditions. And yeah, so this here is just a really good way to preserve your plant specimens that you really want to take care of past the winter season. I'm competing with a crow now. Yeah, so one thing I really want to mention with cannas is they are toxic. Do not eat this plant. So this over here also gives you a lot more space that you have to work with to be able to plant spring bulbs and vegetables or what have you. Never bring anything into your house if you know it's either sick, has fungus on it, or has visible pests. So this over here includes the exuvia of aphids, it includes white fly scale, and many other pests. You do not want to bring that into your house. If it's a particularly expensive variety, you can isolate it and quarantine it from other plants and try to regenerate it that way. And just know the way that your plant grows. So this one here grows basally from ground up. It branches into several offsets. So that makes it extremely suitable for this method. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm going to put these in their own well-aerated bags, just cardboard lunch bags, put them in a dark area that's also light tight because you don't want them to be exposed to light because it'll wake them up again. And then I'm gonna check on these regularly through the season. And after our last frost in the spring, which will probably be about late March this year, I'm gonna check on those new growing points, and if I'm satisfied, I'm gonna plant them back out in the garden and enjoy them for many, many more years to come. So yeah, I hope you guys have a really fantastic day. Stay blessed, thank you for your support. And I just gotta show you guys this. This here is my sunchoke. Look how big this is. It's literally on the other side of the yard. Yeah, that's in the sunflower family. It's got an edible root to it. I'll have to make a video on that later. But yeah, stay blessed. For the Canadians out there, once again, happy Thanksgiving. Yeah, have a good one.